Hey everyone, welcome to the Oasis Podcast. I'm your host, Miss AJ. Thanks for tuning in. An oasis is something that provides refuge, relief, or a pleasant contrast, and that is exactly what you will find tuning into the Oasis Podcast. This is a space where I and special guests will be cultivating intentional and honest conversations about life's journey. Subscribe everywhere you listen to podcasts and watch us on YouTube now. Hey y'all. So this episode was recorded with For the Love podcast, but I felt that this was definitely an episode that was worth hearing again for those of you who didn't hear it. This would be the first time. So enjoy the conversation.
Welcome back to the For the Love podcast. Today we have Miss Ayana and Miss AJ. Welcome back. How are you doing today?
Thank you for having us back. I see you guys are liking us.
You've invited
more episodes.
So honored. We definitely have a new topic today. So let's talk about accountability. What does that look like for you? And, you know, ladies first, we're going to start with you, Miss Ayana. What's that look like for you?
Oh, accountability. That's one of my favorite words, so I'm excited about that. To be accountable is to be responsible. It's to, you know, what they kind of say, like, you know, a man or a woman of your word. Have some moral compass to you and be accountable for what you say and what you do, your actions. Like, you can't blame somebody else for anything that you do. Your actions are your actions alone, and you just have to stand accountable to those things. So I think accountability means responsibility, taking responsibility for your actions.
I mean, that pretty much sums it up. Accountability is basically something that society is lacking.
Mm-hmm. Facts.
We are lacking accountability as a people in general, as a race, gender. There's a lack of accountability, and I think we need to touch that.
Mel ready to go there. We about to go there.
Yeah, let's do it.
Why sugarcoat it? I'm just going to say it off the bat. And I touched it before. And when I said it before, it was more so like, Ayana made it like I was directing it just towards females. But I'm going to say this. Men do not know how to be men. I don't know where it fucked up at, but a lot of these men are the new age bitches.
Some fucking skinny jeans, man. I think that's what did it.
Can we rewind that, play that back?
I mean, it is what it is, man. It's men don't know how to be men, and it's because our fathers, a lack of fathers, weren't there to check us. Our homeboys that are men aren't checking their homeboys that aren't stepping up. It's a full cycle of shit that's making it this way. Society is glorifying the bullshit. Society is glorifying the ignorance. And we are a living stereotype of all the negativity portrayed upon us. And we back it up with our actions.
Yeah.
Well, you got to think, nowadays, people don't like to be told anything, right? Everybody feels like they have life figured out. Broke as hell. Don't know what they're going to do with their lives, but you can't tell them nothing. You know, and you know, Mel, you and I have talked about this before. Mel, you and I have talked about this before, where you have people that have shown those negative traits and you come to them and you're like, hey, listen, you know, this is real off-putting, you know, especially when you're directing it at people that don't deserve it. And that response is, well, I am who I am. You can't change me. You are who you are. So that means, look at your life.
That's a lazy-ass response.
That's why your life is fucked up now. Because you are who you are, and you refuse to grow. To grow is to change. And that's
part of that.
That's anybody.
I don't think anything's wrong with that statement, but for different reasons. And I'm going to pull back and let y'all finish.
Oh, okay.
But you remember the other day, I was online on Facebook, and I had a little conversation with somebody. I showed you the conversation, Rich. Yeah. I showed you also, AJ. And it's like, people just don't want to accept that they play the biggest part in their own downfall by the choices they make. So a lot of people, before we even specify, a lot of people are so used to self-sabotaging and victimizing themselves that it's always the world's fault instead of saying, I chose to fuck up and do this.
Yeah, well, there's another part to that, bro. Being a victim gives people attention. So if you run around, oh, woe is me, life is, oh my God, I can't believe this happened to me. Why does this always happen to me? Well, it's because you've made the same choices. Why is your credit bad? Because you keep spending out of your means and doing stuff. Because think about it. Think about how Walmart is right now. Walmart is lacking TVs. Like, because people got stimulus packages, and instead of being smart, because they want to go buy a 52-inch TV to put in a house that they can't pay the rent for. So it's like,
But you know, a pyramid scheme on Instagram.
Facts. But people like to play the victim because why? Victims get attention.
That's what I was saying. Like,
people love attention. They want all eyes on them, so they're always going to paint a picture so that people can look at them, to see them. And the problem is because they don't see themselves. You know what I'm saying? But in regards to self-sabotage, I did do that episode 20 of my podcast, the Oasis podcast. But anyway.
Absolutely. Put that in there.
But no, for real. Just throw that in there, y'all. But no, self-sabotage is a very real thing. And we do it in so many different levels, but you're absolutely right. People don't understand when you are choosing knowingly and unknowingly sometimes go against what you know is for your betterment, you are sabotaging yourself, right? And that's whether you're choosing the same type of people to date, whether you're choosing the same type of ways to waste money. If you're sabotaging yourself, you're stopping yourself from achieving your goals. You're stopping yourself from being the best you can be. Right.
And that's what
and people, just like what you said, Rich, you're right on the money. God forbid you tell somebody, you know, I don't think that makes sense.
Tighten up. Yeah, tighten up.
Oh, you judging me.
Yeah, that's
you think you better. But and that's what automatically people get defensive. And it's because people hate when there's a mirror being brought to them so they can see themselves. They hate it.
We also got
I think it's also integrity with it. For me, I think you just have to have some integrity and not lie to yourself. A lot of people like to lie to themselves. It feels more comfortable to tell themselves some bullshit than to be real, because being real, you know, takes the level of humility, and sometimes it hurts to tell yourself the truth. But you don't grow. Like you said, there's growth and change, and you can't grow without stepping outside of your comfort zone, stepping into that stretch zone where you got to face some shit that you might not like about yourself. Nobody is perfect. Mm-hmm. And the best feedback I've ever gotten in life most of the time was wrapped in something that I thought was negative, but it gave me some insight to where I can grow and where I needed to be more accountable. But you got to have integrity behind that shit. You have to have some self-awareness. It's a lot of unaware people out here. They're walking around smelling right there.
That's the key right there, to be self-aware.
Yeah, and thinking they the shit. And they not. You not.
Everybody is wrapped up in their own reality in their mind.
Yeah.
And they're wrapped up in, well, I see that you can do this and you can do that, so I can do it. Rather than staying in your own lane, fit your own mold, be aware of your limitations.
Sip your water and mind your business.
But at the same we sometimes put people in a position to fail just because we see so much better in them than they know that they can to reach. Mm. So we want better for people, and they're fine being bum asses.
Mm-hmm.
Well, some people like vision, man.
I'm gonna add another layer to that.
Yeah.
These type of people, though, how many people surround them that think different than them, though?
Right.
They surround themselves with people who are just like them. And if, God forbid, you're just that one in the crew who just evolve a little bit, you now want to vibrate on a different frequency. Guess what happened now? You done changed.
Yeah.
It's you trying to judge me. And it just amplifies this victim mentality even more.
Mm-hmm.
Right? As opposed to, like, we can't be the same people we were at 15, at 20, at 25. You are growing. Your mind has to grow. If you stay the same, you are dead. Like, period. Period.
Man up, so woman
up. Understand that you're not supposed to be the same. You're not supposed to constantly think the same, act the same. And sometimes people around you have to change for you to change too, right? But, and I think
that's sometimes you have to change the people who are around you.
Yes, I love shifting.
It's not just the people around you changing themselves, but sometimes you just have to change the circles of people around you. Like if you think back right now to the people that you grew up with, you know, you probably aren't that tight with all of them. And that doesn't mean that there's anything wrong with them or anything wrong with you. You guys just grew and went on different paths.
Sometimes you outgrow people.
Yeah.
You got to know what serves you. You have to deal with, spend your time, your energy, and your focus on things that serve you. Like, if I'm in a space in my life where I'm trying to get a house, I can't talk to my homegirl who still in their mama house, who, you know, ain't no shade to projects, but ain't paying rent and don't see nothing, don't want to put no money aside. You want to go to the club every week, and that don't serve me. I'm trying to save. I'm trying to stack. Right. I got goals. I can't be on that wavelength when I'm trying to do this for me, because I have to be accountable to myself. A lot of people don't want to do that.
I know we were saying people need to be accountable, etc., but like, what exactly does accountability look like for people? So I think people hear the word, they throw that word around. I think it's a buzzword, and I guess in some circles. But then what does accountability actually look like?
Okay, go ahead, Mel. You go first, and I'm going to tell you what it looked like for me.
A lot of us don't have genuine people on our side, in our corner. So we get caught up with these. Now, listen, don't steal my term. But don't get caught up and these long-term associations, people that we think are friends. Mm-hmm. I've known Rich forever.
Word.
When Rich is wrong, I tell Rich he's wrong. That don't mean I'm not gonna ride with him and do the fucked up shit, but I'm gonna say, yo, we went about this all wrong. We did it all wrong. Maybe we shouldn't do this.
Right.
But accountability has to have some, you have to have that respect for yourself and respect for that other person who you're trying to bring back down to a reasonable level. You got to have a sense of self-awareness. And if you cannot be honest with yourself, be true to yourself, how can you be accountable?
And piggybacking on that too, like to Mel's point, we've known each other for a long time. So like, if some shit is off, we gonna tell each other like, yo, look, bruh, something is not flowing here like it should be. This is what I'm seeing. And you have to be willing to be open and understand that the person that you're talking to, and obviously that's not everybody, right? Because not everybody has genuine people, like you said. But if you do have somebody genuine, you have to be willing to understand that when they're coming to you with this, and a lot of times they're coming to you from a place of logic. Most people cannot think, you can't think logically and emotionally at the same time. And most people, when they do dumb shit, is based on emotion. So most times when your person is telling you, look, this is what I'm seeing, it's from a place of logic. They are not clouded by whatever emotional triggers you had that's making you do whatever dumb shit you're doing. So you have to be able to understand, like, yo, you know what? This person is, they see what's going on and they're able to see it from an unclouded view. They're a little bit higher above on this. Let me listen to them. Maybe there's something that they're seeing that I'm not seeing. Now, does that mean they're going to be 100% right all the time? Absolutely not. But they could see something that can keep you out of a lot of shit because they were looking for it. Trust me. Like, that is a thing.
So here's my question. I mean, I think both of you have, I don't know, Yana, if you wanted to add something, but both of you, I feel, is talking about accountability in regards to external. But what internally? Do you think accountability can happen?
Absolutely.
Yeah, I want to answer.
It's not external, because that's when I think accountability, I think internally.
Yeah,
I want to think about someone checking me so I can check myself.
That's part of being self-aware.
Mm. Yeah. I think accountability for me is saying what you mean and meaning what you say, standing behind what you say, is being able to admit fault,
the
mistake,
right?
To be humble enough to be like, yo, I effed up. I was wrong in this. Mm-hmm. Or I could have done that. It's also, you know, standing in truth. Like, if I say I got you, like, T, you know, I'll let you know I got you. I can't just say with my mouth I got you. I have to show with my actions.
So absolutely.
So when it comes time to it and you come to me, I can't be like, oh, I know I said I had you, but, I mean, Not this time. Maybe next time. That's somebody that's not accountable to their word. It's they're you know, they can't stand on their word. For me, my word is everything.
Ms. Vaughn, and I say back in the day, right?
When I walk into spaces, all I have is me and my word and what I say and what I put into the space. I have to stand behind it. So I can't show up faulty. I can't show up faking. I can't show up lying. I can't show up bullshitting because I won't be able to stand in that. So I have to walk in truth. I think there's professional accountability when you're working in a workspace. You got to be accountable to your tasks. You have to be accountable to people who are waiting for you to do something. Right. In personal relationships, you have to be accountable to the promises that you made to your partner or to the people that you have personal relationships with. Yep. But it's about self. It's like, I want to be stand up. I don't want to be a trash ass person. I want to be stand up. Mm-hmm. That's what accountability is to me.
So, you know, AJ brought up a good question talking about being accountable to yourself. And like, I'm not going to go into a long rant about it, but I'm just going to say this, like our society in general, we've conditioned each other to not be accountable to ourselves. You want to know why? Check this out. New Year's resolutions. How many people make New Year's resolutions? Oh, I'm going to go to the gym. I'm going to work out. I'm going to eat better. And from January 1st until about the end of January, they are in the gym going hard. And then all of a sudden, that's it. That's one part. Then you have songs out there. You got people talking about like YOLO and all that other crap. All that is an excuse to justify you not being true to yourself and not being accountable to your actions. We've been conditioned to do it.
That's true.
Y'all been conditioned to do that.
What you say?
The hardest person to be accountable to is yourself. It's more easy to be accountable externally than it is to be internally accountable.
But you got to care about yourself to be
accountable.
I'm going to keep saying it. You got to be self-aware. Like for me, for myself, speaking only for me, I know I'm an asshole. I accept it. I embrace it. I understand it. I've also learned that. I've also realized there's a time and place for everything.
Right.
There's a way to be tactful in what you do. There's things that are appropriate and things that aren't. So as you grow up and you become aware and you decide to mature and evolve as a person, you realize you can be true to who you are without necessarily offending or being disruptive or a nuisance to society.
Right.
So you have to have that awareness of yourself.
I agree with that. And this is, now I'm gonna go back to that statement I made about individuals who's like, this is who I am, I ain't changing. You know, I'm gonna add a Bob because that's how people be seeing it, right?
Right.
But in all honesty, what Mel just said is exactly the same thing, if you think about it, right? And at least in the way that I interpret that statement. I tell people all the time, I'm self-aware, I've done the work, I know who I am and I know who I am not. So when people come to me with grievances or anything like that, I hear you, right? And there's some things that I'm willing to acknowledge. And acknowledging means I know I do that. Next, right? But does not necessarily mean I'm willing to change that, right? And I'm one of those people, I'm gonna call it out. I'm not willing to change for people's comfortability. I'm just not willing to do it. I'm not. And when I say that, it means this. If it's something about my character that is really rubbing your spirit wrong, I absolutely wholeheartedly accept you coming to me and telling me. I hear that. But it's up to me to decide if it's important enough for me to shift or not. It's not automatically just because you say, oh, I need you to change that I'm gonna be like, sure, right? And that's the thing. And I think when people bring up, are given accountability for certain actions, there's gonna be instances where I might have done something wrong with you and I can acknowledge your feelings about that thing, but it doesn't mean that it's gonna come with an apology. It doesn't mean I'm gonna say, oh, well, I'm never gonna do that again. No, and I think that's part of being accountable too, and being self-aware. I did this thing. I acknowledge I hurt you. I did this thing, and that was not my intent, but I understand that it was the impact. I get that, but I'm being accountable for who I am and also honoring myself. And this just means maybe we just can't flow on this level.
So let me ask you a question.
That's just how I see it. I'm not going to change all parts of me for people just not liking it. I'm not doing it.
Based on you and everything you just said, how do you evolve from that mindset though? Like, I agree with you. Sometimes things are what they are, but I feel that sometimes depending on the complaint, depending on what is being discussed. Sometimes we have to take it into consideration of maybe this would be for the better, for the bigger picture. Maybe it's not that big of a deal where I can't try it your way.
Absolutely. And I think when I say it, and maybe it's the language, maybe it's the passion behind it, it comes out harsh. It's not to say that I'm never going to change, but my change has to be for me. It has to be for me. And I think, and when I say for me, when I think about it, oh, wow, me evolving is for the betterment of this, but it's not solely because you're telling me that you don't like it. That's just how I internalize it. It's like what you said, what would trigger a change for me? When I was younger, back in the day, I'd be like, I was that girl, like, fuck this, this is who you're going to get, and period, right? There was no thinking about processing or anything. Now, I still feel like I'm along those lines, but just like what you said, if I'm hearing the complaint more than one time from different arenas, right? Different people with different statuses in my life, because I'm self-aware, now I got to sit down and think about it. But my thought process is this. Okay, these different people are saying these things about me. Is it true? It's definitely has some truth to it because all these people are saying it. So it's definitely something I'm doing. My next question to myself is, how do you feel about this thing that you're doing? Right? And then if my part of me is like, I like it, guess what has going to happen? I'm going to keep doing it.
So and let me ask not, you a deeper than I like it, thing. Does it serve me though? A deeper
yes, that's what I'm saying. Like that when I'm asking it, right, do I like it? Does it serve me? Is it serving a purpose in my life right now? No, absolutely, Ayana. And if the answer is yes, then now the next part of the question goes, are you willing to lose these people off of this thing? And I have to make a decision there. Because now it's a matter of, are you willing to change for the betterment of you to keep these people around? Or are you going to change this thing because these people say you don't like it, but you think that it serves as a purpose? So I don't think people even give it that much thought. Whereas back in the day, I didn't. Now I do. And this is why I'm saying I'm not just going to be willing to change for anybody. I'm not willing to do that.
And I think it depends on the situation. It depends on the circumstances. But if you're doing something that you know is counterproductive to your best interest, but you like it, then that's not a healthy mindset to have. Yeah. Because then it's like, okay, I'm hurting myself, but I like what I'm doing. And there are examples that you can use that we won't go into right now. But that could be a thing. So then when somebody's coming to you, and it's not like they're coming to you from a place of nitpicking, they're coming to you from a place of caring. Like, listen, what I'm seeing is a problem. And if that's your answer, then it's like, okay, then it kind of puts you back into the headspace. Like, okay, well now I have to reevaluate myself too. Cause if I come to you, hey, listen, this is what I'm seeing, especially if it's directed at me and I've given you no reason to be this way and you continue to do it. Now I got to vote you off the island because I'm only trying to surround myself with people who are going to propel me, because life is real simple, right? People make it hard. The people around you, they can be one of two things. They can be anchors or they can be oars. Are they going to help you row and get moving on in these waters of life, or are they going to sink your ass to the bottom? That's it.
But I think it's levels to it and it's layered. And I think you have to have discernment who's on your team and who's telling you what. Some people give you feedback because it serves them. It serves their self-interest for you to behave a certain way.
Exactly.
It serves their self-interest for you to change something so that it's better for them. And it really isn't to your benefit to follow along. And then you have real people on your team that can really, you know, as I say, pull up your socks and be like, yeah, this ain't what you're supposed to be doing. But I think nowadays, I don't think there's a lot of genuineness in a lot of relationships. Mm-hmm. I don't think people... No. Are telling each other the truth. My village, the people I surround myself with, my select few, we tell each other the truth. If you ain't cute, if you doing something messy, you still my girl. But I'm like, yo, that's hella messy. Nah, don't do that. That's messy. That ain't cute. That's beneath you. If you still decide to do it, I still love you. I still rock with you, but I let you know. I kept it 100 with you because I care about you and I want you to be better than this behavior I see you doing.
Yep.
If and that's I how it should be.
Something harmful, I'm gonna tell you because I love you. I'm not gonna sit here and do the harmful shit with you and act like I ain't got nothing because that's not a real friend. Those are
correct.
Fair weather
friends.
Those are long-term associates.
So many people think friends aren't supposed to tell your friend when you're wrong. You know how many memes I see? You know how many?
That's crazy.
Like, that's the dumbest shit ever. That ain't your friend then. If they can't tell you, you fucking up.
That's crazy. Right?
That's not your friend. But I've seen so many memes say that. Oh, and you see it yourself. You see people that you probably know from high school or wherever, you know, on the block, whatever, and they posting up and so, oh, my day one. But y'all both acting a fool, and none of y'all tell each other to check yourselves. Y'all are foolish. Y'all lying. And then each of y'all is telling other people, I don't know why she's doing it. But then in each other's face, y'all keep keying. That's fake as fuck. That's fraudulent.
Don't call me fucking bullshit, because you're going to get your feelings hurt. I'm not that type of friend. I'm going to tell you straight up. You stupid. Girl, get off my phone. Because
that's dumb. Like, I think that's a dumb move, but if you want to do it, okay. Like, that's what I'm going to say to you. But people don't want to hear that. You know how many friendships I lost because of that? Like, they think I'm supposed to beat up the friend. I was never that friend. I'm never going to be that girl that's going to sit back and let you fuck your shit up. If I do that, I'm not your friend and I don't care about you, period. But people think that, oh, they people know who they can come to for their fuck shit. They know. Mm-hmm. Right, and eventually they're gonna stop coming to you if they know you're not gonna accept their fuck shit, but at the same time they're gonna resent you for not accepting their fuck shit. And right. So then eventually it's gonna cause a rift, right? But and to me it's the dumbest thing ever. Like, if you're gonna, like, exactly what Yana said, like, why would I, if I care about you, I care about your well-being, I care about who you are as an individual,
right,
why would I co-sign your dumb shit?
Yeah,
why would, and you cannot co-sign mine. Slap me across the head, like, bitch, that's dumb. And this is why I had to cut people off. I literally had to, because I was doing some fuck and then people were just letting me do it. And when I started realizing that, like, I'm over here giving you sound advice, and when I'm, like, you know, off my tilt, like, because I had those moments, no one was checking me. You want me to
They like your misery. It was cute. That shit was entertaining. I'm not I'm not here for nobody's entertainment. But yeah, there's a lot of people that are not real with themselves and with each other, and that's problematic. Like, and you is a homeboy, and we really have some, like, harmful ass behavior in our community.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and women sit around and let other women do some trash shit to their children, mm-hmm. or their man. Mm-hmm. Men sit around, let their boys do some trash shit to their women and their children. And I'm like, how's that your homeboy, but he don't take care of his kid? And you know he don't take care of his kid. But that's your dude? Like, that's your day one, A1? How's that your homegirl, and she out here neglecting her children, and she in the streets with you all day, and you know it, and you helping her neglect her responsibilities? What kind of person does that make you?
Exactly. And then it's that also people forget, you know, back in the day, there was this mindset, pretty much, you are the company you keep.
Birds of a feather.
If there's a girl trotting around doing whatever, or she's just not taking care of kids, let's say the example you just used, you know what people gonna start thinking? I can't breed this girl, because guess what she gonna do, right? She think that's cute. She think that's okay. And then eventually people are just gonna assume you are just like this person because you're around them and you're not checking them. So clearly you co-sign them.
Your cool circle with should reflect you. Your circle should reflect you. Nope. That's how, and I
feel. That's why my circle is
growing, change as you grow and change.
Yeah.
A lot of people don't see it like that. A lot of people, they want to acknowledge what they want to acknowledge. Mm. They want to be aware of what they want to be aware of. And I think a lot of people that live their lives in such a fucked up manner, they're doing it intentionally,
mm-hmm.
because they're scared. They're scared to put that effort in. They're scared to evolve. They're scared to step up and grow as a person. They're so comfortable with mediocre bullshit that they will dwell and sit and fester in that shit. And then you got to, sometimes, no matter how much you see and want to help a person, like, yo, you need to step up. You need to do better. Sometimes you just got to let people sink.
Yeah, absolutely.
Right? If you die, you die.
Right? By yourself. I ain't no ride or die. You going to be right
there. Because when I care, I'm going to try. Hey. And the minute you keep pushing me, shoving me, making me the villain, I'm going to be like, cool, you got it. And I'm going to go this way. I'm not going to watch you sink. I'm just going to step away. I'm not going to watch you sink, because that's just fake to me. I'm just not going to do that. I'm not going to take joy from that. It's going to hurt me to see you fail. So I'm just going to be like, I can't deal with this. I'm not going to do this. I'm over here. And you do what you, and then you eventually, you'll figure it out. Because I always say that I had to learn. It's not your business. Mm-hmm. People going to learn when they're ready. They're going to hear when they're ready. That's it. There's nothing you can do.
That's a word, too. You're not responsible for anybody's well-doing but your own.
That's a hard lesson I had to learn. Okay? Nope.
I definitely understand that and agree with that. Sometimes we put ourselves out there so much, and we are trying to extend ourselves to help these people that don't want the help.
Won't save them. They don't want to be.
They'll suck you dry, leave you high and dry, take everything you got, and still be doing the fuck shit that they was doing before you gave them everything you got. And you sitting here like, why am I depleted? Because you're trying to save somebody else. That ain't your business
at all. Right.
Unfortunately, that's because people tend to see more in other people than they see in themselves. So like they see this thing, they feel like they're a sculpture, right? They see this lump of stone and they're like, you know what, I can turn you into a masterpiece, but meanwhile it's just not cooperating, right? Like and that's where people go through it, and that's people feel like they need to save people, like you said. They feel like they can make you be better, but then you have people who know this and they know that they should be better, but because they don't want it to be thrown into their face that, oh well, you couldn't have done this because of me, they will intentionally sabotage themselves to keep you from telling them you wouldn't have done it if it wasn't for me. And that goes for relationships, that goes
for
all of that.
Is a word, Rich. And honestly, like the peace, I've never known peace before I figured out that I'm only responsible for myself.
Ooh, child, say that again for the people in the back. Girl.
Before that, I was trying to do for everybody. I was trying to make mama right, man right, family right, friends right, and it just wasn't right. And I wasn't right. I was neglecting all of me. And then I realized, you don't have nothing but you. When you down and out and you by yourself, it's you and God, for those that believe in God. That's it. I've never had more peace than when I figured out that I couldn't do it for somebody else, that although I can be accountable for others and to others, I have to be accountable for myself first and foremost. Absolutely.
You got to know when to choose you.
Oh, yes.
Right.
I choose me all the time.
Okay, all day, every day. Twice on Sunday.
All the time. Yeah. People will try to make you, listen, like you selfish, and I'll be like, yeah. I deserve it. All these years I've been giving people, I deserve to be selfish. The fuck?
And I love when they say, you've changed. I'm like, thank you for noticing. Thank you so much.
So you know what? I've never had that issue with somebody close to me saying I've changed, just for the simple fact that my circle always been small. And as I grew, they grew.
Mm. Right.
So.
You've been fortunate.
And but you know how I am. I could like you today and hate you tomorrow and not talk to you again. So it don't even matter to me. Like I said, I consider Rich my family. Mm-hmm. So as I done my dumb shit, he was there doing the dumb shit with me. As we became men and we did better, he was there with me. So we got to pick and choose. And if we going to go on a journey and we decided to have somebody tag along, they got to be willing to take the journey with you. And right. It might not be the same journey along the same path, but y'all are going in the same direction.
That's important. There has to be some equally yoked, you know, energy in your team. Like everybody has to want to put on their best. Like you got to be doing your best. I got to be doing my best. And together we're motivating each other to do better. Like if you talk to me about your goals and I'm not encouraging you, I'm not speaking life over your dreams and your goals. Only time I'm interested is in the bullshit. Only time I'm interested is in the turn up and the link up. Like I'm not interested in you. I'm not pouring into this friendship. I'm not pouring into this relationship because I'm not encouraging you to do something different and better for yourself.
You know what that is, though? What you just described? You know what that is, right?
What is that?
Accountability. That's exactly what it is.
Mm-hmm. That's what we've been talking about this whole time.
My question is for you. The question is based off a meme I've seen online. And the question is, when are we going to tell men to be better instead of telling women to choose better? So let's throw this question at Rich first. What is your take on this question?
When are we going to tell men to be better and tell women to choose better?
Right. Instead of telling them, yeah.
All right, so let's make this real easy. Men are going to be better for the women they want to be better for. That's it. So if you got a chick that she doesn't inspire you, not just inspire you, because she's sexually attractive, but inspires you to want to be better, sparks your spirit, sparks your soul, you're going to be a shithead because you don't see no value in keeping her around. If she's there, she's there. If she's not, fuck her. But if she inspires your soul, then you're going to want to be better. You want to know why? Because you're going to want her to be proud of you. You're going to want to do the things that you do and then be able to go back to your girl and be like, yo, babe, yeah, this is what I'm doing. This was going on. And have her be like, yeah, that's my boo. That's what I'm doing. And have that sense of pride as you do it. Because men are very prideful people. And if you don't give us a reason to be prideful in our actions, then we're not going to fucking be prideful in our actions for you. The end.
I hear you. And to go along with that,
okay,
I wholeheartedly believe that women make this decision. And I say that to say, a man can approach you. It's your choice whether you give him any time of day, any, you know, any conversation, any entertainment. A man slides in your inbox. It's your choice to respond or not. A lot of times, women are choosing these men that are bad fathers, assholes, or whatever you want to say. And then they are saying that the guy is making them turn into a woman they don't want to be. Stop picking the same guy. Stop making that decision. Stop trying to change a person that don't want to change.
We're looking at each other like,
It's your choice. A man can see you in the street and be like, damn, he's gorgeous. Let me talk to her. A lot of times I've heard women say, y'all know within the first 5 seconds of talking to somebody, if they're worth your time.
Yep.
So if you know that and you still decide to move forward, that was your choice.
Right. They saw the potential in what he thought he could be. They wanted to be able to mold him. Because I've heard that a lot too. Women want to shake.
She was a good enough woman to change a man that didn't want to change and found no fault in his actions.
So I don't think y'all wrong. I don't think y'all wrong what y'all saying. But in response to that picture, I also fully agree with it. And so when it's saying, you know, we so busy really telling a woman, society loves telling women what the fuck to do, period. They love it. They love it, especially when it comes to relationships and choosing who you
are. Oh, my goodness. There's so many magazines about it. Essence, Jet, all of them.
Y'all control the key. Y'all have the most power in this fucking world. Y'all control the narrative. Yeah.
Where?
Y'all control the... When I say that, I say this. And I'm talking about society-wise. We're not talking about government shit. We're talking about society-wise.
Mm-hmm.
Just your basic... Say just... Let's minimize it to just the community. Women compete with each other, first of all. So if we say, as women, we're not going to accept certain shit from men. We're no longer going to deal with the men that aren't being terrible fathers and not there for their kids. We no longer are going to deal with the men that refer to as bitches and things that way. Men are going to conform because they're everything they do to get the attention of women. So if you have a man that has a 9-to-5 job and is doing everything he needs to do as a man, as a father, as a provider, and he wants to include you, but you choose Dope Boy Jerome, that was your choice.
Yep.
Well, see, now I agree with women and choice, and that women need to make better choices for themselves. Mm-hmm. I don't disagree with that. But in this conversation, I haven't heard yet that men need to be better. And we had a previous conversation where you said men don't know how to be men.
No, men don't know how to be men. And I feel like if I see somebody that I consider an associate fucking up, I'm going to say, yo, don't do that. You're fucking up. But also, we live in a society that minding other people's business gets you in a worse situation.
Or deeper than that, we live in a society that perpetuates the sexist behavior that women have to deal with women. We live in a society where you are the man if you got several women. You are the man if you have certain status and access and you out here doing certain things. You're a player. Like, we live in a society that shoots the narrative of boys will be boys. Yeah, and women got to do better. And I believe everybody has to do better. I believe women have to do better and men have to be better men.
No, right. And I agree with that too. But let's look at the reward situation with that, right? So you got men, especially if you have men that were raised by their mothers, right? A lot of men who were just raised by their moms, their mom gives them this narrative that, hey, listen, you got to be a gentleman. You got to be nice. You have to be chivalrous. You have to do all of these things. And the little boy grows up because, yes, that's what he wants to do, right? But like we had talked about before, you know, you meet three or four chicks in a row that you're doing all the things that your mother taught you. And to Tamel's point, you're getting shitted on for, you know, dope boy Jerome or the dude that did her dirty. Then what's that going to do for you? You're only going to touch a hot stove so many times before you stop fucking touching it. So then you're going to be like, you know what? Clearly what I was doing didn't work. Let me do something different. And then they do something different. And then unfortunately, they're being rewarded for it. So this, it's a cycle. It's
and on the flip side of that cycle is a woman who says, yo, I had enough of the fuck shit. I had enough of the fuck boys. I don't want that no more. I'm looking for a man that got his shit together. And then they try to hold dudes accountable. And dudes are like, I don't got to deal with this shit. It's three, four bitches around the corner that's going to take my shit.
Now, this brings me back to what I said. This brings me back to what I said. You now deciding that, you know what, I'm tired of dealing with the fuck boys, right? You made a decision to change. I'm going to deal with this type of guy now, or I want to deal with this type of guy. But now they got so used to the girls that kept shitting on them when they tried to be that type of guy.
Right.
Now they're dealing with the girls that accept the bullshit.
And vice versa.
And so how does a person who wants better for themselves win in this game, in this rat race?
You find somebody that's on the same page.
And I ain't going to choose better.
Find somebody that's on your page. Find somebody that's willing to evolve with you. Some people are meant to be fucked and not fucked with.
Amen. Can you put that on a shirt?
I buy it.
Yes, that is. Now, that's a word. Okay, I know it's not Sunday. It's Saturday, but that's a word, folks. Y'all heard that? Some people just fuck them and then leave their ass where you're left in that.
Exactly.
After you pull your pants up, leave their ass right there.
Some people aren't meant to join you on your journey.
But not drop your seat and go.
No. Don't do that. Don't do that. Strap it up.
This is
got enough broken homes.
The process comes into play, right? Because look at it like this. You go back 20, 30 years, right? Even the whole dating pool was different.
Yes, it was.
On two or three dates, and they didn't have to go on a date with the same person. They went on dates with different people all the time, right? And when they finally found somebody that they meshed with, then they went steady with that one person. But now the way society is set up, you go on two dates with somebody, and let's say you talking to somebody else, and that's both men talking to other women or women talking to other men, then all of a sudden these people feel entitled. And it's like, oh, well, we were talking. Yes, we were talking, but we weren't dating. We are not together. I don't owe you a fucking thing.
I'm happy a man.
Right. But I think people need to be clear and establish that thing, because some folks sell a dream. We got to talk about the people that be bullshitting and selling dreams, too. Oh, if you are talking to people, multiple people, let those multiple people know.
Be honest about
you ain't the only one. I don't have no problem.
Whoa. So wait a second. And I'm gonna generalize this because I know not every female is like this. Y'all say y'all want the honesty. So a man comes to you and is like, yo, you're not the only one. And they will feel like, what you mean?
And that's fine. They can feel how they feel.
Right, exactly. Or a man could be like, listen, with all due respect, I just want to fuck you. And they'll be offended. What do I look like? What type of woman? I'm not no hoe. Why you got to be a hoe? Because I want to fuck you.
Right.
That's all I see between me and you.
Right.
We got to start. When we ask for the honesty, we got to be able to accept the honesty.
I agree with that. But dude, listen, dudes can't take honesty either.
Not at all.
Dudes don't want to hear that shit. They don't want to hear it's the next nigga on the line. They don't who's that calling your phone? The next nigga.
Absolutely. No, you're absolutely right. It's a pride thing. But unfortunately, most people, both men and women, like to be lied to. You want to know why? Because there are times where you will ask your significant other a question that you know you don't want the honest answer to.
Do I look fat in this dress?
What did you say? Oh, yeah.
Do I look fat in this dress?
Yeah, like you'll ask the
I don't really thing. Think women be asking that. T, I ain't never asked no man that.
I ain't never asked no man that shit.
I don't want the answer.
Hold on. AJ, you asking anybody that? For real? Of course
Thank you. But I don't.
Nowadays, not maybe not so much with that, but people will intentionally ask a question that they really don't want the actual answer to. They want to agree to that.
I definitely agree. People like being lied to because they like living in the lie. But right, I think
people like to be lied to, but in the same breath, people are also still afraid to tell the truth. And when I say that, people are afraid to tell the truth. That's true. A level of brevity. It takes a level of also being confident in yourself to be able to tell someone the truth. Mm-hmm. A lot of people don't have that. And when they say, a lot of people love to say, they like to quote unquote stay away from conflict or they want to save someone's feelings. That's bullshit. They just
are afraid
to deal with the exactly. They're afraid to deal with the outcome.
You better have a sense of
and no then you problem. Get labeled because we the last time we had a conversation, you were like, yo, back in the day, like I was like a nigga. Like, and I know from the place that you came from, because I was definitely like that. A woman who just tell it like it is, be upfront and honest. She's not feminine enough. She's not ladylike enough. She's not a wife. You got to put her in the pocket. You can't talk to men like that.
But let's look at the flip of that, though, because you bring up a good point. But then a dude who isn't being ultra aggressive and he's talking to you and not at you and he's trying to listen to what you got to say, then y'all get bored with him and all of a sudden he's too nice. And obviously, we've had that conversation, AJ. Like, now
I'm not in that pocket. Please talk to me nicely.
Because when I thought
Ayanna likes compliments.
No, but even when I was like in a different mindset, I still didn't want her dudes. I still didn't like that shit.
No, I don't like all that shit. I don't like that rah rah.
I don't like it.
I like
a man who's street smart, but not of the streets.
First of all, watch how you talk to me, okay? I'm triggered. I got triggers. I got past traumas and triggers. Watch how you talk
to me. It shouldn't go down. Okay? You ready to go to do what you got to do? But I don't. You're not talking to me crazy because we're gonna.
And my mouth is wild crazy. So if you get disrespectful,
I don't care.
My mouth is wild crazy. If you get disrespectful, I'm gonna get disrespectful back. Watch how you talk to me. Talk nice.
This is why I don't. Okay? I zip it up. My mouth is hella reckless. I get it from my mama.
Like, I do think that people I think that men need to hold themselves accountable. Like, yes, I agree with everything that you said, Rick. And I agree with everything you said, Mel, about the fact that men are motivated by what they want to get. Men are motivated by the chase, the prize, and they will do what motivates them. So if a man wants to do better because he wants to provide better for you, then he will. But I think going back to the original conversation we had about accountability and self-accountability, I think men get away with having less self-accountability. A woman has to be something for herself. She got to have some shit together for herself, or she gonna be treated like she ain't nothing. She gonna be treated like she gutter. She gonna be treated like she ain't shit. A dude doesn't necessarily have to come to the table having shit about himself, and he will still get a basic level of respect that a woman will not get if they are both the same type people.
A lot of times relationship goes wrong. And again, you guys can fight me on this, but I just feel I'm a woman, this is perception. I see a lot of times relationship goes wrong. It's, for me, the first thing I hear is they asking a woman, it's a you question. What is it that you did? What is it that you could have did different? What is it that you allowed? What is it like? And it's like, whoa, what if I came to the table properly and in every way that I could have? Why is nobody out here questioning homie, right?
It's not even a situation where it
was no cheating. They said no cheating or nothing like that. But a lot of times it's like, what is it that, why didn't you do everything you could have done to save the relationship? Why is it that you
couldn't? Because a woman is supposed to keep a man. That's a side.
Well, here's the thing though. Hold up. It's not a matter of saving a relationship, because like Mel said earlier about people growing, you could have grown different. You could have brought everything to the table, and so could he. And guess what? Because you guys grew different, your goals were different, your drive was different. You just grew differently. So anybody who's coming to you and trying to blame you for it, that's just ignorant.
That's a fact. But I've been in
situations where it was clearly unequally yoked, and I was still asked, like, well, why didn't I? And it was crystal clear. You put the scoreboard up for my partner and I, my ex and I, and it was like, yo, ride or die. This, everything checked off, and it was still like, well, why didn't you just do a little bit more?
It's like, wait, you know, men cheat. You know, that's just something you got to, you know.
But if a woman cheat, the first time a woman cheat on a man, he out because his ego hurt. His pride hurt. How dare she?
So here's the question with that then. The people who asked you, you know, what you did wrong, what did they actually have invested in your relationship to instantly blame you and to feel comfortable enough to blame you? So clearly, they probably weren't even happy in their own situation because they wanted you to wallow a little bit in your own.
Oh, yeah, they was miserable. Yeah, I admit to that.
You
it was miserableness.
Okay, the situation being done, but because they want you to wallow in your own shit, it's like, well, what did you do? You
could. But society wants women to wallow in the shit. A man is never told, stay down,
to the
bro.
Next. Yeah, it's fine. This,
you know what? She gonna get better, bruh. She don't suck your dick like you want her to. She'll get better. She don't cook for you, bruh. She'll get better. They told, go get the next chick. Women are told, stay down till he get it right.
Maybe before.
Men are not told that.
Maybe before. Nowadays, it's totally different. It's totally different nowadays.
How?
Because, again, this brings me back to men don't know how to be men. Women don't know how to be women. The roles have changed in a sense to say, like, women saying, fuck it. I'm going to do me. You doing you, I'm going to do me.
That's
You heard that out there.
And there's a lot more fathers that's stepping up and taking over the child rearing responsibilities and have to fight in court for years to get their kids. Meanwhile, the baby moms is doing dumb shit and they're still fighting super hard to get these kids. So like Mel said, the roles have definitely changed. There's far more fathers out there trying to be dads and men because they already understand the impact they have on their children's lives. So it's not
hats off to those that step up. But I think in society, the expectation for a woman to endure in a relationship is always deeper than the expectation for a man to do better.
Well, you know what? I'm gonna bring up something then.
Wait, before you start, fellas, if you're listening, do better. Just do better.
It's a fact. Thank you.
Stop blaming on the other people. Stop being a victim. Accept the accountability in your flaws. If you haven't been a father, step up, be a father.
Public service announcement.
If you haven't done what you were supposed to do for your lady, step up, treat her better. Because if somebody like me had to be a father to your kids.
be a better daddy than you are. Facts.
But you're absolutely right. But here it's gonna wrap all together. This individual though needs to be self-aware enough to be accountable for their shit.
Thank you. It goes back to accountability. It dead drops back to self. Because the same thing that you just said to the fellas out there, we can say to women, like, yo, women, if you're trash, do better. Like, you treating these dudes like trash, do better. If you lying.
There's toxic women, there's trash-ass women.
Yes, there's trash mothers out there. If you a trash mama, if you a trash toxic baby mama doing some petty shit because you mad he done moved on, cut that shit out.
But you know what's funny about all that?
It's a fact.
A lot of times, and y'all mentioned this, birds of a feather stick together. If you see a trash mom, she probably got trash-ass friends back in her life.
It's a whole flock of them. Pigeons. Whole flock.
Yes.
So think of it like this, right? And just kind of touching on what AJ was saying earlier, right? About people coming to her about things that she might need to fix and her trying to take into accountability or take into account what they're saying, right? So even the president has a cabinet. So why would you think that when it comes to life things that you shouldn't have at least one or two trusted people who are able to think objectively to help you make better decisions. Because nobody's all knowing. We all make mistakes. We all make decisions based off of the information that we have. So why would you not want to have somebody who you know is in your corner that's going to be like, listen, based on this move right here, there's a pitfall. I need you to chill. Look at what's going to happen.
People that don't want that is people that don't want to be accountable.
It's not... Well, I mean, I don't know if you're targeted to me when I brought
no,
that
just,
up.
No, just in general.
Oh, I mean, I think sometimes too, being real, and I can talk from my situation, for me, it was not that I didn't want it. It was literally because it wasn't there. And like, I had to be introspective. I had to, because I wanted different. I had to stop myself and be like, I wanted different. I literally was at a point, you guys had mentioned, where I was doing toxic shit. I was doing shit that was not okay. And I sat there and said, this ain't okay, but guess what? It makes me feel good and I want to continue doing it. I literally had this conversation with myself. And I had to get to the point where I was like, we need to cut this shit out because now it's just not, it's not serving me, like what Ayana said. When I made that decision is when I had, that's when I was able to scan around and go, but who here is someone that could be a that could mentor me, who I could actually talk to, right? Who can provide me something different? Who's going to tell me the real truth and not off of jealousy shit, not off of some I envy you shit, not off of some I hate on you shit, not off of some I'm going to encourage you to do continue to do bad shit because my life is fucked up too. And I had to take that. I had to take that assessment. I had to look around. And then what I realized is I got to cut all these bitches off.
Right. And there has to be a readiness to receive. I've learned that too in relationships, that people have to have a certain readiness to receive and see it in themselves and see it for themselves before. Because people, listen, you know your own dirty shit. You cannot lie to yourself. When you lay in your bed, when you are by yourself on your pillow, you know the ins and out of your mess. So anything that somebody brings to your attention, you already trying to cover it up, lie about it, or ignore it and repress it. But it has to be an open channel of being able to receive it. I've had friends that have come to me at points in my life and be like, this is not you. This is not Ayana. And I wasn't ready to receive it. I wasn't ready to hear it. So I was like, whatever, girl. And I stayed in my mess. And then when I was in the point where it, again, no longer served me, and I had those, I knew I had those people behind me that already let me know this ain't you. Then I was able to come to them and be like, yo, you know what? I was tripping 6 months ago, 6 weeks ago, 6 days ago. Mm-hmm. I was tripping. And you really, you came to me, you let me know. You right. This ain't me. This don't serve me. I need to do something different. But if you don't have anybody in your circle that loves you enough, because that's love. To tell somebody about themselves means I love you.
Sure?
If I'm just your yes woman and I just make you feel good by telling you BS, I don't really mess with you. Mm-hmm. I'm not really your people. But if I love you enough to be like, that does not serve you. Yo, you drinking every day. Every time I'm on the phone with you, you got another bottle done. I think that this is not, this behavior doesn't serve you. Right. You can't tell somebody that you're not really their people.
Right.
Got to understand who really rides for you. My friendships are great. We have a good time. We kiki and all that, but we get real with each other. We tell each other the truth, honey. And that's because we have established that we give a fuck about each other and we want the best for each other.
And people say they want real, but they, just like what Mel mentioned, they ain't ready for it. It's not true. They don't.
They can't be my friend, Chuck.
They want real unless it's something they don't want to hear.
You can't be my friend.
You can be real as long as it's something that they're not willing to change. They're not willing to accept for themselves.
Yeah.
Other than that, they want real. It's like, oh, yeah, you don't want it real. Like, you want nothing to do with that.
And I think that tacks back to the meme that Mel brought up with the choice, woman's choice, and men doing better. Like, they're not going to do it unless they want to, both a woman and a man.
Right.
Woman's not going to choose better till she wants to, and a man is not going to be better until he wants to.
But there's the flip of that too, right? Because there are a lot of, you know, dudes out there that might be a good dude that was dealing with shitheads. And they knew that the girl was a shithead when they got with her.
They know, and then they got entwined and stuff.
Yeah, they knew it. But that's because, unfortunately, and I'll tell you from a guy's perspective, they look at shit a little differently. Like, women look at men in terms of, okay, who's going to be a good mate? Who's going to be a good provider? Who has the potential to be a good provider? Whereas men tend to look at women first as far as who's more attractive, and dudes will deal with some bullshit for a chick that they find really attractive, even though she might not have anything to offer besides her physical appearance. And that's where people go wrong, because they'll be like, yeah, she's attractive, you know, she got a nice body, whatever, but she ain't doing shit with her life. She's not. Why do you think this whole concept of having like sugar babies and all that other shit is a thing? Dude's willing to spend money on somebody who's eye candy. She offers no substance whatsoever, but she's cute, so he deals with it.
That's like, it. The shiniest apple could be rotten on the inside.
I think, yeah, it's absolutely, and I think it's twofold. Gold. This issue is twofold, honestly. Mm-hmm. Where at one end, it's like, just what I said last time, I think we all, men, women, those in between, need to be more cognizant of what we are allowing and what we are perpetrating, right? Like, when you are sitting here, like what you said, you just said, Rich, oh, you know, men, she look good, she ain't got shit, then, all right, I'm still gonna fuck with it. And then when things happen and it goes left, issue. Same thing with women. We make choices of like choosing dudes that, you know what, we knew was not for us, was mm-hmm. not okay. And then when the shit goes left, all right, now it's this whole other thing. And we need to be real cognizant of what the fuck we're doing and why we're doing it. And it's not a matter of blaming other people. It's a matter of
self-accountability.
You chose that shit. Just like what Mel said. Yes, bitch, you chose that nigga. Right?
Right.
It's like, homie, you also chose to fuck with her too.
Right, your baby mama that you can't stand?
Yeah.
You was deep up in the guts. You ain't had no problem. Now you can't stand her.
Right.
You made that choice. Your baby father that ain't shit. He was still ain't shit before he was your baby father, and you let him become baby
number
father.
One, and he still wasn't shit with baby number two.
Thank you.
It's still more choices. Just be ready to deal with the consequence.
There you go.
People always feel like they could change somebody.
Yep.
You can't change nobody but yourself. You can't change nobody but yourself.
It's hard as fuck.
And changing yourself is hard enough already. Exactly.
Yes.
Working on you is hard enough already, but you really can't change nobody else. You don't have that control. Even your children, even the people who come through you, you can't change them. They are themselves.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Right. You can help influence, but you can't.
Exactly. Exactly. Mm-hmm. That's crazy. I let that go. Let that go. Let that desire to want. I'm telling you, that's how I keep my edges. Okay. That's how my skin is so clear. Because I let that shit go. I was like, I'm not doing it.
Clearly, I didn't let it go because that's how I lost my...
Oh, bro. See, you could have preserved your edges.
Lost them shits a long time ago.
Let that pressure go. Let it off your chest.
Your hairline. You know, you got to keep the
hairline. It's all right.
My hair follicle game is gone. So
it's all right. Your beard connects. That's all that matters. We don't really need the hairline. We just need the beard to connect. And we straight.
And the truth of the matter is, honestly, like, for real, I know we joking, but, like, the truth of the matter is, the quicker and sooner we are accountable for ourselves, the less shit we allow ourselves to get into, honestly. Because you're going to have to, you think about it a little more, because then you know, I'm like, yo, if this shit go left, you going to be looking and feeling real dumb. And you can account to that, you know what I mean? Like, this is what's gonna happen. You already see it. You just get this foresight. You just get it. Like what Ayana said, your discernment becomes so much sharper.
That's it.
Right? When you learn to be more accountable. And then you can then be able to dodge and weave these shit that's thrown at you. Like it makes it so much easier. It makes it so much better. It really does. It gives you a sense of clarity and peace.
It's true.
But the work is hard. It's hard. But it really is worth it. Like, it really is. And you're going to realize that life just eases the fuck out.
Right.
Right. You don't even have half the drama you had before.
People get confused by a smile. That's what it is. They see a smile and they get confused. And they
think, ooh, you better, kingdom. Bitch, you better give that word.
Yeah, in the animal kingdom, if you look at it, both lions and gorillas bare their teeth before they fuck you up. Mm. But you see a smile and you be like, oh, yeah, let me walk towards it. Nah. They may not be smiling. They might be baring their teeth, preparing to rip your ass to shreds. And you're going to walk into your own demise willfully.
That's why I'm covered in prayer and discernment, okay? God gives me insight. I go,
sage and all that.
Just God is the sage. I do it all. I got the crystals. I got the sage. I got the altar. I make sure all my ancestors
evoke and woke. Listen.
Okay? They evoke and woke for your ass. They working before I get there. They all in the atmosphere before I show up, so I can just show up and be chill, okay?
Listen.
That's it. I go inward. I have learned, and I'm a Gemini. I like to be sociable. I like to be all in everybody's face. And then I had to take a moment and say, do you know yourself? You put on these airs, you put on these whatever you put on when you out and about. Mm-hmm. You play these roles for everybody, but what are you for yourself? What do you have for yourself that is yours? And I had to go inward, and I had to work on me and tell myself some really ugly truths. Like, this ain't cute, sis.
Yep.
Let's fix this. This is toxic. This doesn't serve you anymore. This behavior doesn't serve you. This mindset doesn't serve you. This action or inaction doesn't serve you. Let's switch some shit up because you want to be better for you. That's accountability for me.
That's it.
So, ladies and gentlemen, I think we all agree that a lot of these motherfuckers just need to become self-aware.
Hey, I wish they could hand that shit out like a pill, like the Matrix, red or blue pill.
Learn yourself before you become toxic to everybody else.
That's it. And stop bringing your drama to other people. Keep that messy shit to your mama. Go home to your mama. Yeah. Mama is the only person obligated to deal with that.
They can't go home and have conversations. So.
Stop pulling it to the
Again, I'm going to direct it to you. Let's do better.
Thank you.
Let's do better for ourselves. Let's do better for our kids. Let's do better for our ladies.
Yes.
Let's do better.
What Lauren said, it could all be so simple.
Yep.
It could be all so simple.
Make it hard.
But guess what? We choose to make it hard.
Right.
Because that's what society glorifies.
I promise
I'm doing my part. Love. Fellas, if you associate with me and you fucking up, I'm going to call you out on site. You're fucked up.
Get him.
All you fellas not taking care of your kids, y'all are assholes.
Get him.
Take care of your kids.
Facts.
All y'all cheating on y'all girls, don't let them find out.
See? Hey,
bullshit.
I'm kidding. Just cut it out. Let's try to be better. Let's do better.
Right. Do better. If you know better, you do better. Do better.
The fact.
Okay.
Word.
And better looks sexier anyway. A dude that do better is sexier anyway. Okay.
Hey, but hold on. I need y'all to talk to these scallywags out here.
Ballhead scallywags.
Listen. Okay, if they got hair, wigs, weaves, whatever, just tell them, cut their shit out.
It's a fact. Listen, I'm a strong believer, and spirit tells you to run, sis, fucking run. Your job is not here to fix a damn person. It's not build a bear, right? It's not build a nigga. If his mama couldn't raise him right in the words of K. Michelle,
amen.
What makes you think you gonna do better? Okay, so
you and your mama.
No, the only person you can control is yourself. And if you're having a hard time doing that, it's probably best you don't get into a relationship. Figure your shit out before you open
right. Ladies, unload stop being toxic.
To somebody else. And fucking sex, dick, pussy, whatever, it's not gonna fix shit.
No.
It ain't going to fix nothing. So don't, and if you feel that's all you have to offer, you got bigger problems too.
Yeah, for the women out here who have a mindset of looking to come up on a dude, I'm going to come up, I'm going to use it for what he got. Women out here trying to trap dudes because that shit is real. Stop that shit. Yeah. Women out here trying to set dudes up for the okie doke. Stop that shit. Just do better. Be better. Have a better mentality. Every man can't pay for your father's mistakes. Every man can't pay for the last nigga's mistakes. Every man can't pay for what your mama, your daddy, your grandmammy didn't teach you. You got to learn it on your own. Like, you have to become a better person because you want to be a better person. And then you can be somebody's woman. But if you're trash, you're going to be trash single. You're going to be trash together. You're going to be trash separated. Just do better. Like,
do better.
Do better.
Word.
And stop stripping that man. Look at mistake and give him some head. Okay? You got to do that too.
Hey, you know, Ayana, say it again, Ayana.
Put a mistake and give him some heads. You know, there's that rhetoric of happy wife, happy life. What's up? Listen, happy spouse, happy house. Keep your man happy too.
Hey,
some shit that's a word. For your man.
Oh, God.
Okay.
All right. So on that note, we're going to cut it off right there. Ladies, thank you so much for joining us again. You know, it's always cool having y'all in there. Thank you very much.
Good
do it
yeah.
Today's Connection Corner, I leave you with a post from Kira J. It reads, "You have to learn the difference between someone disrespecting you versus you feeling disrespected. Emotional ears hear from a place of offense. Sometimes it's not what they said, it's what you are triggered by. And unless you know your triggers, you'll see everything as an attack." Thank you for joining us.
Thank you for tuning into this week's episode of the Oasis Podcast. I hope you were able to find something that resonated with you on your journey. Don't forget to subscribe everywhere you listen to podcasts and YouTube. Rate us and leave us a review and comment on Apple Podcasts or iTunes and YouTube. Share your favorite episode and like us on Instagram and Facebook. If you have any questions, comments, want to be a guest, or have show ideas, contact us at ajaysoasis@gmail.com. That's ajaysoasis@gmail.com. Or direct message us on Instagram or Facebook.